Howdy, this is Mike Fossum. Am I talking to Aggieland? Howdy! Oh, that's great. That's great. No, it's my honor to speak to you and the students. This is something I've wanted to do for a long time, and really it's a great for me to share this experience of being up here with you guys.
How do you think going to space has changed your perspective on life?
This is now a reality, but it started as a dream when I was 11 years old and watched the moon landing, the first moon landing on Earth, our first moon landing, and then, you know, within a year or two, I started thinking about, you know, like every red-blooded kid on the planet, you know, I mean, I want to do that, but I didn't really think it could come true. And to be able to, you know, be fortunate enough to, you know, to be living and working here right now is just about beyond comprehension. But it goes to show that anything really is possible. You have to stick to it. You have to believe in it. You have to work hard, reach, you know, always find ways to reach and to knock down, go around, or climb over barriers that are in your way.
And I was curious, how has been a member of the Corps of Cadets help you in your life and your career, sir?
I needed a dorm room. Dorms were full. Apartments were too expensive. I had hair down to my shoulders. If you join the Corps, you got a dorm room. And so I was sold. And that's absolutely a true story. That being in the Corps and open up a complete progression of life events that really got me here today. Because again, when I went to A&M, I had no intention of going to the military, but really for me, one of the keys was working as a flight test engineer and having a flight experience in the Air Force that gave me a skill set that happened to be something that matched up with skills that NASA needed for this kind of job. But I would not be here today if it wasn't for, you know, having taken that fateful step, cut my hair and join the Corps.
Well, thank you for coming, and, you know, we'll say bye to Mr. Fossum. So hopefully he's hearing us.